हेलो, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर अमित कुस्ताड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम PEVPIT बुदगांव सांगली। थ्रू दिस वीडियो आई एम टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू ड्रॉ अ बेंडुवेन डायग्राम फॉर कंटिन्यूस बीम। बिफोर डायरेक्टली गोइंग टू द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस वीडियो, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू दैट इफ यू आर नॉट सीन माई प्रीवियसली अपलोडेड वीडियो, दैट इज कंसेप्ट ऑफ सैगिंग एंड हॉगिंग मोमेंट, प्लीज वॉच दैट वीडियो बिकॉज that concept is required while drawing a Bandwagon diagram for continuous beam. You can watch that video by clicking on the link which is provided in the description box. Now let us come to the problem of continuous beam. So this is a continuous beam. It is an indeterminate type of structure. To draw a Bandwagon diagram for indeterminate type of structure, we have to draw two diagrams. And just we have to overlap that two diagrams, then we'll get final Bandwagon diagram. So this is the overall procedure of drawing a Bandwagon diagram for indeterminate type of structure. So first step, we'll go for drawing free Bandwagon diagram. So here, first of all, just we'll draw a deflected shape because of application of this clockwise movement. So here I have drawn this deflected shape. Here this top of the beam is in tension, bottom is in compression. Here top of the beam is in compression and bottom is in tension. So our sign convention is TCS, when the T stands for top of the beam, C for compression, S for sagging, TCS. So here top of the beam is in compression, that's why this portion is in a sagging moment, and of course this part is opposite of this, so that's why this portion is having hogging type of bending moment. So while drawing a free Bandwagon diagram, the positive side is drawn on upper side and negative side is drawn on below of this baseline. Drawing a free BMD means just we are going to consider that beam AB as a simply supported beam and beam BC as a simply supported beam. Okay, so this is just a free Bandwagon diagram. Positive side is on upper side, negative is on lower side. Now next, we'll go for drawing a support BMD. To draw a support BMD, just we'll draw curves like this at every joint. Just draw curves like this. Next, suppose we solve this example by slope distribution method, moment distribution method, or by stiffness method. Then we are getting these answers. Here, some answers are negative and some answers are positive. What it means? Negative means it is an anticlockwise, positive means it is a clockwise movement. Now, just put the arrows. MAB, we are getting negative. Negative means anticlockwise. Just show arrow like this, anticlockwise. MBA, we are getting positive. This is MBA. Positive means clockwise. Just show arrow like this. Likewise, show all the arrows. Now, if you observe all the arrows, all the arrows are below a particular baseline. That means at every joint, they will exist a hogging type of bending moment, and hogging is shown negative. So this is the support BMD. While drawing support BMD, negative part is drawn on upper side, that is hogging bending moment at A, at B, and at C, that is at every support there is a hogging type of bending moment, and this negative part is drawn on upper side of a baseline, and positive side on below. So this is, we have drawn a support BMD. Now next, just we are going to overlap free BMD and support BMD, then we are going to get a final Bandwagon diagram. So here, just observe the sign conventions. Here this positive side is drawn on upper side, here negative side is drawn on upper side, because just we are going to overlap free BMD with the support BMD, of course, positive and negative, these are the opposite sign convention. So from positive side, negative side must be subtracted. That's why this positive side is drawn on upper side, and here the negative side is drawn on upper side. Now just we'll overlap this free BMD and support BMD. Here we are getting this final Penduman diagram. So finally, just this is the, suppose here this 12 is this totally positive part. From this positive part, this much negative part must be subtracted. This much must be subtracted. That's why this is the remaining positive moment. Okay. So this is the final Penduman diagram. So this is green portion is showing a positive moment, and this orange shown is negative Penduman. So likewise, you are getting a final Penduman diagram.